My next guest is truly family to me. I mean, for 8 years, I had the pleasure of working alongside her. She's my soulmate. She was the one I went to whenever I had a problem. She's the great, great. I can't even imagine doing a show and not having her here for my first week. Here's one of my many favorite moments.
I should be very annoyed with all of you for waiting up. But I'm not, because I want to share something with you. I've been pinned. What?
Where's the pin?
My pin. It was on my sweater. Oh my gosh. I found it.
Now she's on Broadway in a play called The Oldest Profession. Please welcome my dear friend, the wonderful Katherine Hellman, ladies and gentlemen. Hey! Thank you. You hear the music?
I do hear it.
They had our music. I
all
love
right.
that.
When we stood backstage and you said, all right, let's get our head in the game.
Let's get it, right?
We heard that music every week. It was wonderful.
I miss you so much. I do.
Thank you.
It's great. It is great to be. I'm so pleased you're here. I mean, it wouldn't be right.
No.
You know, you have to.
I have to be.
And you look beautiful.
Thank
and,
you.
And you just, really. I kid you not, you know, when I first got Who's the Boss, I was still young and running around, and there were a lot of times when I needed to talk to somebody, and I, of course, went to Katherine. And so you remember the first time we met?
Oh, I do, because we were off hustling.
Yeah.
Yes.
Which is what actors do,
yes.
You know.
Believe it or not, we have to be selling all the time. So I fitted right into The Oldest Profession because they sent us off in a plane and we were selling our shows. We were going to Vegas.
Now, wait, wasn't Who's the Boss, though? It was before Who's the Boss.
Yes, absolutely.
It was when, you know, Katherine was so great as Jessica Tate in Soap. God.
And you... You were doing Taxi.
I was doing Taxi.
And so we were in our seats, and away we started. And this person climbed over the seat, came right down in my face and said, "Hi, I'm Tony Danza." And I said, "Yes, I know." And he said, "You do?"
Well, I had a huge crush on your character, and on you, you know. And then, and when we found out, I'll never forget when I found out that Katherine was joining Who's the Boss, I was like, oh, now I got a shot. Yeah. Now I really have a shot. So you, you know, I talked to Alyssa the other day. You talked to anybody?
Oh, yes. I, you know, Danny, I see. And I talked to him, sweet Danny.
Oh, I love him, boy.
But
I
keep talking to him like he's got a bowl haircut and is 7 years old.
Yeah,
he's a grown man.
Yeah, he's a grown man now. And he graduated, I don't know if you know this, Danny Pintaro, you know, played the little kid on the show. He graduated from Stanford.
Yeah.
He was really very smart kid. And Alyssa called me.
Yeah.
She said she's coming in to do the show for me.
Great.
I was really happy about that.
Remember when we were working and they brought their report cards? And Tony was really very good with the kids, wonderful with them. If they tried to eat sugar or anything sweet in the morning, he would take it out of their hands, throw it in the trash and say, no sweets. And when Lent came and we all had to give up sweets, all of us, and the kids would mark off how many days left till they could have sweets.
Yeah.
But Tony used to do their report cards and put them up on a bulletin board. And when the network people and the writers all came for run through, he'd make them go over and look and see how the kids were doing in school and make sure that everybody knew that they were doing very well in school. They were terrific kids.
Oh, they were great kids. We were very lucky. I mean, you know,
and
how they turned out is indicative of that.
Absolutely.
You know, Alyssa's unbelievable. Danny's, you know, really stand up kids. And
they
it's
were.
Really.
And very professional.
Oh, let me tell you, we were like a crack troops. One of the things I remember about Katherine, which was great, we used to do this thing on the show. We were always very worried about the audience, right? We tried to make sure that the audience was didn't have to sit there all night and, you know, go through it 14 times.
Yeah.
And one of the things we had to do was we had to change in between in between the scenes.
Lots and lots of clothing that we wore. So Tony used to go out into the audience entertain, which he's doing right now. It's a wonderful extension of what he does very well. And then he would time us to see who got out first.
Who changed fastest.
And he said, okay. And he had a bet on which woman would get out first. And so I was always...
And guess who always won?
I was... I didn't always have on the same shoes. I would be so fast at getting out there, but I always won the bet.
Always won the bet. Listen, when we come back, brace yourself. You know, Catherine was also, she's a machine. She never makes a mistake. She gets a laugh every time. But we went back and we found a couple of bloopers. So you won't want to miss this. Come back and see it. Back with my dear Catherine Hellman. And so, Kat, you know, we were looking for stuff. And like I said, you were the consummate professional. She's a machine. I mean, she's known. And you give her a joke to get, she gets the laugh. And she very rarely makes a mistake. But, you know, we found one.
Oh,
let me
where?
Show, let me show you one.
All right.
I am not going
this.
To let her ruin...
Hold it. Hold it. Hold it. On your coffee break.
Well, not for at least a week. Not since Angela.
Tonight we have a match.
Okay.
Well.
You caught me, but I have one on you too.
You got me?
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. So you're not getting away with this.
Well,
All right.
Guy's working on it, but I gotta go teach my class. So could I finish this line when I know it? Come on, seriously. I need your help here, Mona. This next line's a problem too. I didn't have to ask, and I didn't ask, and I didn't have to ask because I don't know this line either.
Yes, I made a lot of mistakes. So, Kat, tell me about the new show. I'm so sorry I've been here, but next week I promise. I've been a little jammed up here, but I promise.
Well, your flowers came instead of you, and they were beautiful.
Well, that's great.
And I knew you were there in spirit.
And it's called the oldest profession.
And it is exactly what you think it is.
Yes, I had a feeling. And I don't want to say anything, Kat, but this is starting to get into a pattern here.
I think so. But we have like 5 old war horses up there. My husband said he had never seen so much acting in his life.
Oh, really?
Just everybody yelling and screaming and crying and fighting and consoling one another.
Sounds like a ball.
Oh, yeah, it's a lot of fun. And we've had a good time working. You know, a new play is hard.
Sure.
Very.
This is a new play.
Yes.
Vogel?
Paula Vogel.
Yes.
Yeah, and so it's at the Signature Theater where they do all of her work for a whole
season. And
she's
a Pulitzer Prize winner.
Yes, for How I Learned to Drive.
Right.
And then this play hasn't been done before. And then after this one, they will do all of her other shows, you know.
Okay. So how long are you going to be here? I mean,
I'll be here through October.
Oh, fabulous.
So you'll get
so
over
me and you, we're going to have dinner, we'll hang out,
we'll
you know
talk.
What I mean?
We'll have some lasagna.
Look, so you gotta go. Go catch Catherine on Broadway in the oldest profession at the Peter Norton Space. Catherine, thank you so much for being here. I love you so much. We'll be right back, folks.